Communications. I've been working on this area for some years now, and especially my area of interest is in 3G and 4G wireless communication systems. Just trying to sort out some problems here. Some people have problems in the audio, and so as I was saying, my focus and currently and my area of research is wireless communications, especially 3G and 4G wireless communications. Manipal Institute, are you able to see me? Good morning. Good morning, Government College, Bangur, Bargo. Okay, so very good. I think the audio and video are good, so people are able to see me. So as I was saying, this course and my research interest is primarily in 3G and 4G wireless communication system. And this is a nice course. This is a nice platform whereby I can reach a large number of I'm able to reach a large number of students to directly convey some of these ideas, especially some of these latest ideas in wireless communications. So before I start, I think there are some residual problems. I think some of these problems are, I mean, these are going to be there constantly. So these are, hopefully these are being sorted out by the technical support at IITM. But by and large, looks like everyone is able to hear me. To just to get an idea, let me start interaction with some random college so that I can just get a feel of what the interaction is. So let me just here go back to PSGCT and let me just start the interaction. PSGCT, are you able to see and hear me?
Sir.
Are you able to follow what I just said? Raise your hand if you're able to follow what I just said. All right. Okay, great. Good. So everyone is enthusiastic, right? It's not. I'm sure everyone had to wake up early today to come at 8 o'clock. Is anyone feeling sleepy or everyone is ready for the class? Everyone is ready, right? Some of the camera is at an angle, so I cannot see the faces of the people. Let me try interact with some others. UIET. UIIT Chandigarh, right? Sorry, I cannot see you. Suddenly, the video has disappeared. Chandigarh, can you see me now? Very good. Can you hear me? Can you hear what I'm saying? Okay, all right. I know in North India it is slightly cold, so it's very difficult for people to wake up. I don't know how much is, what is the temperature in Chandigarh?
8 degree.
8 degree. In Kanpur also it's 8 degree. Probably in South it's a little bit easy. I had to wake up the whole today morning. It was very foggy, so I hope some of you didn't have any problems coming to the class. All right. So what I was saying is basically my interest is 3G, 4G wireless communication systems. I hope everyone is here. The other thing I want to see is now several people have asked me what I'm going to cover in this class. So I've been receiving several questions. Sorry, some problem with audio. So several people have asked me what I'm going to cover in this class, and I told several people this is the first time I'm doing this class. So unfortunately, I don't have an idea of what people know really at this point of time, and more importantly, what people are expecting is to know what I'll be going to cover. Which means, for instance, I don't know if the students here are by and large undergraduate or there are some postgraduate students also. That is the first thing I want to understand. And then I also want to get an idea of what is the background of these students. For instance, how many students are familiar with the basic knowledge of wireless communications? How many students don't even know the basics of communications? How many are PhD level students who are purely looking for research aspects and things of that sort? So everything seems fine. So this first class, what I want to do is there are two things. Actually, I've been instructed, because many colleges are not on the line yet, so I've been instructed to spend some time trying to acclimatize people with the trying to go a little bit light in these first few lectures, so that those who join later, will not have a problem trying to absorb this thing. So I'm going to keep this first few lectures light, but I will also use this time productively. I'm trying to get an idea of what you are familiar with so that I can gear my lectures, I can tailor my lectures towards what is best suited to the interests of a large majority of this community. Is that fine? So let me just start interaction again with someone. For instance, Oxford College, let me start interaction. Let me see. Oxford College, are you able to hear me? Are you able to hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, okay, thank you. So temperature in Bangalore is okay, right? In Bangalore, everything must be pleasant.
Yes, sir.
So you had no problem waking up today morning, I'm assuming. Unlike here in Kanpur, where it's foggy and even difficult to get here. All right, okay. So what is the composition of the class at Oxford? Is it undergraduate or is it postgraduate? What is the composition? What is the interest? Can I get some responses from the students? Just let me just get some responses.
Undergraduate.
Which year undergraduate?
Final year.
Final year, right? Final year undergraduate. Any postgraduate, PhD or master's level students in the audience?
Not
many masters. Okay, so predominantly undergraduate students, and you have done a course on communications, I believe. Undergraduate communication, like digital communication and so on. You are familiar with these concepts, basically. Basic concepts of communication.
Yes, sir.
For instance, let's say I talk about match filtering. Some of you are familiar with match filtering?
No.
Match filtering has been taught?
No, it is not taught.
Match filtering has not been taught. So you are familiar with analog communication, basically AM, FM and those kinds of thing.
Yes.
Okay, okay. So digital communication you are not familiar. How about BPSK, QPSK, the modulation? Are you familiar with modulations?
Yes.
Okay, so you are familiar with digital modulation. Okay, so I am getting the Oxford, it's primarily undergraduate students, so they are familiar with basics of digital communication such as modulation, but not match filtering. All right. So let me just go to some other college and try to see what is the kind of composition. So there is Manipal Institute of Technology. Let me just talk briefly with Manipal Institute of Technology. Manipal, can you hear me? Students at Manipal Institute of Technology, can you hear me? Manipal, can you hear me? I think there are some problems with this Manipal Institute. Can you resolve it, Ratish? Can you see? I think the bandwidth is low at Manipal. So MUJPR. Let me just start interaction with this college. Okay, not publishing video, so I cannot really see. Goethe Institute of Technology. Let me just try to see if there. Goethe Institute of Technology, can you see me? This is Professor Aditya Jagannatham from IIT Kanpur. Can you hear me? I think there are some problems with this. They can hear me. VCAP, let me go to VCAP. Let's see, try to see. VCAP, can you hear and see me?
Hello? Yes, sir.
VCAP?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
You can see me? You can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Where is the college? Where is this college again?
Andhra Pradesh Bhimavaram.
Andhra Pradesh Bhimavaram. Okay, okay. It's close to Rajahmundry. Okay, so I have some questions for you. If you can hear me, can you answer these questions? I'm just trying to find out what is the background. Are the students here undergraduate students or postgraduate students? And what is the background? Undergraduate students, is it? Are you familiar with digital communication, basic concepts? So students here, have they done basic concepts on digital communication courses? Are you familiar with the basic idea of digital communication? That is what I am trying to ask. Such as match filtering or modulation, BPSK, QPSK. I see. So let me just ask one more, which one? Government College of, let me see if I can start interaction with them. Government College of Engineering, Gur. Bipin Kumar Tripathi, Bipin Tripathi Komun Institute of Technology. Okay. LNM, can you see me? Lakshmi Mittal Institute of Technology?
Yes, yes.
You're able to hear me? So students are also undergraduate here also? Can you hear me?
First year and BTech fourth year.
First year and MTech first year and BTech fourth year. I see. So what I'm assuming is looks like most of the students are undergraduate, some MTech first year here and there, but it seems to be an exception. So most of the students seem to be undergraduate. And some students, as I'm getting a feeling, some students are, many students are familiar with communication. But I think last time I was also told that some students here are from a computer science background, that is not from electrical engineering, but from a computer science background. So some of those students, I think from, especially from UIET, I think UIET just sent me a message that they're doing, they have done information technology, IT in their sixth semester. So some students seem to be from a computer science background, but majority of some students also seem to have come. So what I'm getting a sense of is that basically this is a course as a mixed audience. So there seem to be students from all different kinds of backgrounds with different levels of familiarity of relating to communication systems. So what I would like to do here is the other thing. So I've now got a basic idea of what is the background of the different students. So what I have had an ability to understand is basically what students are comfortable with, more or less. What I also want to understand from you is, what do you expect in this course? Can someone tell me, can some of you participating colleges, can you tell me? Because you also have some expectations, right? Everyone is coming to attend this course. So you also probably have some expectations with respect to what kind of topics do we expect to cover in this course. I'm not promising that I can cover all the topics, but depending on what students are expecting, if I get to know an idea of what you're expecting, that will help me better tailor the topics and better tailor the content so as to suit the interest, so that I can stress on some more, stress on others less. So that way what I will do is I'll try to, as much as possible, I will try to tailor it as to what are the needs without repeating on what has already been taught, like the basics, but directly going to some of the concepts which are more important, which will help you probably in your project and thesis and so on. All right. So I just want to start with someone who can give me maybe Chandubhai S. Patel, Institute of Technology, because I didn't have a chance to talk to them. So Chandubhai Patel, unfortunately they are not publishing, looks like there is some bandwidth issue, so they cannot, I'm not able to, there is a GCT, just trying to get in touch with GCT. GCT, which college is this? GCT?
Hello.
Hello, which Hello. College is this, please? Hello?
Sir, we are from Tamil Nadu, Coimbatore, sir.
Achha, which college is this? What is the name?
Government College of
Achha, Technology. Government College of Technology, Coimbatore. Alright, very good. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So did you, were you able to hear what I just said regarding the course and regarding the content of the course and so on?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you're also undergraduate students predominantly, right?
We have master's level students here.
Okay, so some master's level students also. Okay. And what is the background, computer science or electrical engineering?
Both computer science and electrical engineering.
So both computer science and electrical engineering students are there. So computer science students, you must not be familiar with some of the communication concepts. But anyway, I'm going to keep some aspect of it general. Of course, this course is more geared towards students from with an electrical engineering background. But I'll try to see if I can make some concepts general so that computer science people can also understand. And so what are you expecting from this course? What kind of topics are you expecting from this course? Can you tell me an idea? Let me just write down some of these topics so that everyone can see what I am writing down. What are the topics that you are expecting from this course? Okay, research and development. So, but what is the research and development? I can write here. I will write here, I think I don't, because I want to see this video. So research and development, where was it? Yeah. Oh, okay, okay. So research, good. So there is a significant amount of research interest. What are the topics that you are looking for in research? When you are saying research, what are the topics that you are looking for? What are the topics that you are looking for? Specific research topics that you are looking for? Okay, so you're looking for some wireless networks and computing. Okay, so some wireless networks, some computing. Okay, very good.
Yes, sir.
So there are some students who still have some. Can you hear me or can you not? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Okay. So I'm just going to go to colleges, try to see what they're expecting in terms of this thing. Let's see if Gokte Institute of Technology is able. Gokte Institute of Technology, are you able to see me now? I think you had some issue earlier. See and hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, so if you students here, they're masters or bachelor students?
Hello? Yeah.
8th semester students. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and you are a faculty, you must be a faculty member. Okay, I'm just trying to understand, what are you expecting from this course? What are the specific topics? Is there anything particular that you're expecting from this course? What would you focus? What are your expectations? That is what I'm, what are the kind of topics that people are looking to? And by the way, is it electrical engineering students or?
Yes, sir, it is electronics and communication plus IS background.
Plus IS, information systems background. Okay, and what are you expecting? What kind of topics are you expecting from this course?
Actually, my students have the background of AC and DC fundamentals.
Mm-hmm.
Analog communication and digital communication fundamentals they know.
Okay.
And they will be studying cellular communication in the coming semester.
Okay, okay. So you are studying cellular.
4G.
Okay.
3G, 4G, TDMA.
Okay, 3G, 4G, some aspects of TDMA, okay.
TDMA, CDMA.
Okay, 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 fine. TDMA, CDMA, okay, I got it.
Yeah.
So you're looking basically at some aspects of cellular communication, 3G, 4G, and basically some of the multiple access standards, TDMA,
yes.
CDMA, OFDMA, something of that sort. All right, very good.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
So let me go to some others, try to get a, thank you. Let me just try to understand from some others. LNMIT again, let's see LNMIT. LNMIT, what are your expectations in terms of topics? Can you just tell me a word or two in terms of what you're expecting?
Something on existing network protocols to communicate in a
wireless. Existing network protocols, all right. Existing network protocols. So wireless communication. Existing network protocols. All right. So network protocols. Are your background your CS background? So network pro. Let me just write it. I'm just trying to make a list of it. Obviously, it's the content is diverse. It's not able to, for me. It's not able to. But I will try to see if I can find some of these things, especially when I talk about 3G, 4G standards. If you can talk about some of these network protocols, especially what are the, because wireless cellular itself is a huge thing. Can I, if I can talk about some of these protocols, at least for the air interface and so on, I'll try to see if I can incorporate some of these aspects. So here students are from electronics and communication or computer science?
Electronics and communication.
EC. Okay. Let me just go to some other institute and try to get an idea. Bipin Tripathi College. Just try to see. Bipin Tripathi Kumaon. Bipin Tripathi College, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
I see, I see. So, how many students are there, undergraduate or postgraduate?
There are postgraduate students, sir.
Okay, some postgraduate. Any undergraduates?
Possibly, there will be some students from CS.
Okay, okay. What are your expectations in terms of the topics? Can you tell me what you are able? can you tell me suggest a few excuse me okay MIMO so you're looking for some MIMO OFDM and those concepts okay some of the advanced wireless concepts okay
and
okay
some software related to some tactical software
okay
related to wireless field.
Okay, fine. SMIT, can I try to interact with SMIT? SMIT, first time this is the thing. Which college is this? SMIT, can you, SMIT, what is the full form?
Morning sir, can you hear me sir?
I can hear you, are you from SMIT?
Yes sir, Sikkim Manipal Institute of Technology.
Sikkim Manipal, where is this again?
Is in Sikkim, in the state of Sikkim.
I see. Very good, very good, very good to have someone from the state of Sikkim. You are able to hear me?
Hear you loud and clear.
Very good, very good. So, this is undergraduate students or postgraduate students?
We have undergraduate students from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering.
I see. Can you just pass the mic? Can you just tell me a little bit and also tell let the students tell me what are your expectations in terms of what you're expecting? What are the topics that you're expecting?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. So I'll just give you a big background of the students that they have learned till now. They have basically done about the analog communication systems. So digital communication system is part of their current curriculum right now, current semester. So they've just started with the digital communication part. So I'll
hand
over the mic to one of the
students. I see.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, can you just tell me a little bit about what are the topics that you might not know the entire topics, but can you tell me what would you expect from this course? What are your expectations in terms of this course?
In this course, we are studying regarding wireless communication. So I guess cellular communication is a part of it. We might also have some lectures regarding satellite communication as well.
Satellite. I'm going to try it, but I'm not sure considering the diverse nature of this. But it's good to know that people are interested in these kinds of things. Satellite communications. Keep that in mind. And wireless. Of course, you said cellular communication. Can someone else tell me what are you expecting from this course? Someone is asking me to increase the volume. I'm just trying to see there is a help here. I'm just trying to see if I have some volume issues. Meanwhile, can you continue please? Can you tell me what your... There is some problem with volume. Speaker volume, can it be increased? Can the volume be increased? Acha, volume is being maximum. That is what I'm being told. Volume is maximum. That is what... Okay. Okay, that is for SMIT apparently. Okay. So new users are being added. So let me just get some quick comments. Yeah, go ahead please. Just get some of your quick comments regarding what you're expecting.
Topics like Wi-Fi, WiMAX, ZigBee.
Wi-Fi, WiMAX. Okay, great. Thank you. I'm glad that you raised it. Wi-Fi, WiMAX. Very good. So basically some cellular and LAN standard. Very good. I'll try to see what extent I can cover things. Thank you. I got your feedback. Let me just give it to one last user before I start with this. So there is a PECUT college. I think I don't know which college this is. PECUT. I think some students are coming in. Which college is this?
Earlier it was Punjab Engineering College.
University. I see. Very good. Sorry, is my volume a little bit loud or is it okay? What is the volume? Should I decrease or increase?
It's perfectly fine with us.
It's perfectly fine. Achcha. Because I'm not sure. Some people are saying lower. So this is, and again, undergraduate students, I believe. Mostly undergraduate students from electronics and communication.
Yeah, we have final year undergraduate computer science students.
And what are you expecting in terms of the content of this course? I mean, what are the topics that you are expecting? I mean, you might have some expectations, right? What would you like to see being covered in the course?
Of course, the fundamental of wireless communications followed by 802.11 protocol stack and after that cellular communications.
Okay, 802.11. Can everyone see what I'm writing? I'm just writing it a little bit. 802.11, and then I'm writing something on the whiteboard. Can everyone see me? I'm writing what I'm writing on the whiteboard.
Yeah.
You can see me. I just have a list of topics, just a sprinkling of this. Obviously, you can see it's fairly diverse from MIMO to OFDM to cellular and so on. So I don't know how much I can cover because I'm told it's only 12 lectures or something of that sort. I'll try to cover the best. My main idea is, so let me just, now without talking to any college in particular, this is my, because I can only interact with a few of them. Unfortunately, that is a limitation of this thing. So I hope everyone can hear me. And let me just say what the intention of this is. Now, in this course, I basically the kind of things I would like to cover. See, I'm told that there are only 12 lectures in this course. Now, I don't know if that is actually, I don't know if it's 12 lectures or, so looks like the number, this is a pilot program, so the number of lectures is few. Now, given that, and the amount of material is huge in if you look at 3G, 4G wireless communication. So there is 15 lectures apparently, I'm being told by IITM. So there are 15 lectures, 15 hours. Now I teach this course at IIT Kanpur, which is a wireless communication. It's a full-fledged graduate course. It's a M.Tech / PhD level. That is, it's a sort of has acquired a core status where a lot of almost all students from M.Tech and many students from the PhD level do this course. So the way it is taught at IIT Kanpur is basically it is taught very rigorously, very mathematically, in a sense to basically lay the foundation with which students can do research. Now obviously that level of this thing is probably not suitable for this kind of an audience, which is primarily composed of senior level undergraduate and some M.Tech level students, because the background might simply not be there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to see, my main aim is try to basically help you basically get an idea of what are the current research topics in 3G and 4G wireless communications. Meaning I would like to sort of start from the fundamentals. Basically, my job here is to basically give a good idea of what are the fundamentals between these various, what are the fundamental concepts in this wireless, related to wireless communications, so that you can use this as a starting base, as a good base to understand the rest of the areas. I don't know if I'm being clear enough, but there are some fundamental aspects of wireless communications. There are some concepts. Again, let me just quickly change the viewers here. Let me just go to SGG SIET. I cannot see the video from SGG SIET. It looks like the I can see the video now. SGG SIET, can you see me? Can you hear me? SGG SIET, can you hear me? MUJPR, let me just try to look at this. MUJPR, can you hear me? MUJPR, can you hear me? Okay, let me just go to RV Institute of Technology. Can you hear me, RV Institute of Technology?
Yes sir, we can hear you.
Okay, very good. So you've been hearing what I've been saying so far? You're able to hear what I said so far?
Yeah. Actually, students are not there because it's a very foggy. It's a very foggy morning right here.
Where is this college?
This college is in the, you know, nearby Dehradun. It's in Western UP. UP West.
Okay, no, so you can understand. I'm also in Kanpur and it's very foggy over here. The whole Northern India region is very foggy. So I think it has been difficult. Totally understand. Very good. So let me just go to Oxford. Let's try to see if they are able to follow what I'm saying. At Oxford, are you able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so my basic idea, as I'm saying, is try to give people an idea of some of the fundamentals. Of course, it's not possible to cover everything in detail. So some of the fundamentals, for instance, many people said about a lot of these specifics. For instance, people talked about 3G, 4G, TDMA, CDMA, MIMO. But there are some things which are very fundamental to wireless communications, which not many people have mentioned, which shows to me that people are familiar with a lot of these buzzwords, but there is a lot of understanding that is needed in terms of the fundamentals. For instance, the most fundamental thing in terms of wireless communication is a concept of fading. What is fading? What is a fading wireless channel? Now, what is a fading wireless channel? How does fading impact wireless communication? What is the concept of diversity and so on? Now, these are some things, these form the stepping stones of wireless communications, right? So to understand 3G, 4G, to understand CDMA, to understand MIMO, in my opinion, you have to have a good, solid understanding of these concepts of diversity, concepts of fading, concepts of what do you mean by probability of outage, concepts of what do you mean by bit error rate. So my idea is going to be to stress on the fundamentals so that everyone has a good grasp on the fundamentals rather than go into the very specifics, because the specifics I think become very particular in one thing which don't have a bearing on general research, and also specifics are different for different people. Someone might be working on MIMO, someone might be working on OFDM, someone might be working on satellite. So what I want to do is for all these people, instead of going into the specific to suit one group of, rather than suiting one group of people, I'm just trying to focus here on the basics so that it suits a broad set of people. That is my intention here. I hope what I'm trying to say is clear to everyone. So what I'm going to do is, so there are some students who want to start interaction. There is Manipal Institute of Technology. Manipal, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Manipal, good morning. Go ahead, please.
Sir, we have both UG and PG students.
Okay, you have UG and PG students. Good. Good to hear that. How many UG, how many PG?
Around 16 students.
Okay, your volume is not high. Can you increase your volume a little bit, please?
Can you hear me now, sir?
Now I can hear you, but still it is slightly below normal. Yeah, go ahead, please. But that's fine, go ahead.
Both UG and PG students, and we are covering the subjects in UG as well as PG level.
Okay.
So can you speak more on what are the projects we can do in this? Because it will help our students when they go to 7th semester for projects.
That is my idea. What I'm trying to say is here, I'm going to cover the basics. You are saying some of the subjects?
No, sir. We have mobile communication in UG level, which we are teaching curriculum.
Right. I got an idea. So you're probably teaching communications at 2G, some 3G and 4G also. My idea, what I'm trying to say here is, see, wireless communications is a very solid field. It has a lot of analytical concepts. If you look at current research, for instance, a lot of these things are research related to things such as MIMO, FDM and so on. So my idea is trying to give you an idea of the fundamentals, something that are related to, I don't know if I'm audible, things are related to fading wireless channel and basically diversity and so on, so that you basically understand. So let me just, in this first lecture, without let me just to get hit the ground running over here, let me just get started with some of the concepts. So what I'm going to get started out with is basically try to see an idea of again, I've been told to keep it slightly light in the first few lectures because several colleges have not joined yet. So let's just get started with a basic notion of wireless communication. Again, many people must be familiar with the notion, idea of wireless communication. Thank you. Right. So several of you must be familiar with wireless. So there is a TKMKTL. I don't know which college. TKMKTL, which college is this? Can you hear me? TKMKTL. TKMKL. Kerala. I think the college from Kerala is, if I'm not mistaken. Is it? Looks like they cannot hear me. SCGSIT, I think I already spoke to them. Okay, so let me just get started with some basic let me go to Chandubhai Patel. Let me just try it. They're not able to publish video. Raisoni Labji, I've not interacted with them. Raisoni, can you see me? Can everyone see me? Raisoni, can you hear me?
Hello. Yes, sir. Hello.
Raisoni, can you tell me some of the popular 2G standards, 2G wireless standards?
Hello.
What are some of the popular 2G wireless standards? Can some of your students answer what are the 2G wireless standards?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah. Sir, we want to basically cover GSM related particularly.
Okay, okay. GSM is a GSM is an old standard.
Yeah.
GSM is an old standard, and I want to cover something in current research, that is 3G and 4G wireless communications. Right. But we are going to start with the basic idea of what is this thing. Can you tell me, can some of your students tell me, because I want to make it interactive, can some of your students tell me what are different 2G standards they are familiar with? Can some of your students answer this question? What are the 2G wireless standards? Can you name a 2G wireless standard? 2G wireless standard.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Sir, second generation and third generation.
That is what I'm asking. I'm asking you a question. What is the second generation standard? I'm just trying to start with. Okay, let me just start with some of them here. So basically, let me just give you an idea. For instance, GSM, right? Everyone is familiar with GSM?
Yes, sir.
Everyone is familiar with GSM. GSM. GSM stands for, what does GSM stand? Everyone see what I'm writing? I think.
Yes,
everyone,
sir,
can see on the whiteboard what I'm writing. GSM stands for, what does GSM stand for? Can someone answer?
Yes,
I'm not able to hear. Can someone answer? I'm not able to hear. What is GSM stand for?
Global system.
Global system for mobile. Okay, let me stop.
Yes, sir.
What is the approximate data rate of GSM system? What is approximate data? What is approximate rate? Voice rate for a basic GSM system. Voice for voice call. What is the approximate rate?
Not getting.
You're not able to hear. Okay, let me just quickly go to some other college here. Government College of, I think it has been Government College. Let me just go to the Government College of Engineering. Government College of Engineering, can you hear me? I don't know which Government College this is. Government College of Engineering. This is Government College of Engineering, Coimbatore. Is this Government College of... Hello? I can hear you. I can hear you, ma'am. My question is, what is the basic rate, bit rate of a GSM communication system? Some of you are familiar with that? Okay, there are some people who want to start the interaction. Let me go to VIT. VIT, JPR, which college is this?
Sir, Vivekananda Institute of Technology, Jaipur.
Where is this? Jaipur. Yeah, go ahead, please. Did you hear my question?
No, sir, I don't know about, we have a topic about Li-Fi, sir.
Okay. So looks like I think I have to go to LNM. Let's see LNM if someone can answer my question. What is the basic rate of a GSM system? LNM, can someone?
So 270.833
KB. Okay, 270.833, fine. So that is the aggregate data rate, correct. 273.270, let me write 270, what? What is the rate? What is the unit? 270 is the number. What is the unit? Bits per second, kilobits per second. You can reply in chat also. If someone would like to reply in chat, you can reply in chat also. Yeah, go ahead, please. LNM.
So KBPS.
KBPS. Okay, so everyone can see it probably. I'm just trying to write it here. 270 KB Yes, and this is the, so 270 kbps, that is an interesting number, that is primarily the aggregate data rate. Can everyone hear me? This is what is known, this is not the data rate to a particular user, to all the users put together in one GSM band, which is typically shared by about 8 users. So each user will have a data rate, so per user it is actually only a fraction of the data rate after you remove the user. So per user the data rate is around 10 kilobits per second, around 10 to 15 kilobits per second. I'm not saying data rate, it is voice rate. Basically if you are in typical GSM phone call, after you remove the overheads, see this 270 kilobits per second is shared by 8 users, and then you remove the overheads, it is approximately 10 to 15 kilobits per second. So per user, everyone see me, everyone can hear me what I'm saying. Manipal Institute of Technology, 13 kbps, yes correct. Manipal Institute of Technology is saying 13 kilobits per second, that is correct. Raison is saying 56 to 115, that is also correct, because as we said that is the data rate, that is when you talk about GSM, when you talk about edge and other standards, but basic GSM voice call itself is around 10 to 15 kilobits per second per user, right? Everyone can, everyone can hopefully everyone can, let me just here go to this Chendubhai Patel. I think I've already spoken to Chendubhai Patel, Oxford. I've already spoken. Let me just go to PSG. I'm not going to PSG. PSG Coimbatore, can you, are you able to follow this what I'm saying?
Yeah, hello.
Hello, go ahead please.
Yes sir, we can hear you.
So what I'm saying is GSM per user for a voice call, the basic data rate is 10 to 15 kilobits per second. Again for CDMA, I think everyone is hopefully able to hear, CDMA also, 2G CDMA, second generation CDMA, I don't know if you can see me, CDMA, everyone see what I'm writing on the white wall? You can see it? Which is also known as the standard. Does anyone know what is this? Is the IS-95 standard, IS-95 wireless communication standard, which has a data, which has a rate for a voice call again around 10 kilobits per second, 10 to 15 kilobits per second. This is a standard that is used in North America. This was a standard that was predominantly used. So these are the basics. Of course, these are the 2G wireless communication standards. These are 2G. These are 2G wireless communication standards, which is a second generation. It stands for, what does 2G stand for? PSG? Second generation, right? So these are second generation standards. The basic data rate is around 10 to 15 kilobits per second. Now, how about some advanced standards? 2.5G, 2.75G, have you heard about these standards? 2G, 2.75G standards, some of you can tell me what are some of the standards which are after the 2G standards. Can someone reply on chat also? Go ahead please.
GPRS?
Okay, so I'm getting a request from Manipal. Manipal, you're asking me to write this thing. Yeah, this is the initial part. I'm not being very specific about what I'm writing, so I'm not paying much attention here. I hope you can see me. In the future, I'll be a bit more careful when I'm writing equations and so on. I'll try to write in an orderly fashion here. This is,
I'm also trying to adapt to this thing. Okay.
Raisoni College GPRS, very good. Thank you. Manipal Institute 100 kilobits per second, I don't know which option. So someone said GPRS from PSG? GPRS, so I'm going to write here GPRS. What does GPRS stand for? Can someone tell me what does GPRS stand for? Okay, General Packet Radio Service. General Packet Radio Service. What is the approximate data rate of GPRS, General Packet Radio Service?
34.
What is the data rate per user in GPRS? Okay, let me go to some other this thing. Raisoni, let me try to go to Raisoni because looks like I think I didn't get a chance to interact. Raisoni, what is approximate data rate for GPRS? What is approximate data? Looks like you are answering some questions. What is the approximate data rate for GPRS?
For Raisoni, it is 80 to 100 kbps.
Around 80 to 100 kbps. Fine, I'll take that answer. Around 80 to 100 kbps. 80 to 100 kilobits per second. Here it's around 80 to 100 kilobits per second. Fine. Can you tell me another 2.5G standard, 2.5, 2.75G standard? Can someone tell me? GPRS is one. There is another one also.
There is the 2.75G.
Okay, edge. Very good. What is the data rate of edge? Can someone tell me what is the data rate of edge standard?
Maybe up to 153 kbps.
About 153. Actually, it can go even higher. Can go up to 3.5. So let me just go to some college. Let's try to see if you're able to hear me. VIT Jaipur. I've already gone to VIT Raisoni. I think I've already went to Raisoni. UIET. Let me just go to UIET. Let's try to see. We are getting closer to the time. UIT, you are able to hear what I've said so far? Hear and follow what I've said so far?
Hello?
UIT, are you able to follow what I'm saying so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so edge, are you familiar with edge? Edge standard. Okay, so some in UIET are not familiar with edge. Okay, let me just go to someone. That's not a problem, but I think Manipal is also trying to interact. Let me go to Manipal. Manipal, can you tell me what is the full form for edge? I think in Manipal I'm not able to interact with Gokte. Let me go to Gokte. Gokte, are you able to hear what I'm saying? Gokte Institute of Technology? Gokte Institute of Technology having audio issues. Are you able to hear what I'm saying?
Yes, I'm audio.
Okay, can you tell me, are you familiar with EDGE?
Yes, sir, it stands for Enhanced Data, it's for Global Evolution.
GSM Evolution, correct. So I'm going to just write this down, Enhanced Data. Everyone hopefully can follow me. Enhanced data for GSM evolution. This is basically has a data rate. So you are familiar with what is the data rate for edge? Some colleges are replying to me. Manipal Institute has replied to me. Raisoni, I think, also has replied to me. Government College of Bargur, I think, also has replied. PUCUT. So it looks like people are familiar with it. Gokte Institute, do you know what is the data rate for GSM, approximate data rate for edge? Okay, as everyone is pointing out, approximate data rate is around 300 kilobits per second. People can say it go up to even 500 kilobits per second. So let's put it around 300 kilobits per second. These are the approximate average rates. Edge, which is a 2.75G standard, 2.75 generation, by which it means that it is basically somewhere between point that is second generation and third generation standard. It's a data standard. Unlike a voice standard, which is only meant for voice phone calls, edge can also provide internet access, basically data access or packet data access. Right, so these are some of the basic 2G standards. So I'm also trying to get an idea of how much people are familiar with. So what I'm going to do is, we are out of time. Right, so I'm going to stop this lecture here, and what I'm going to do, let me just give you an overview of what you're going to do. Of course, this is the first lecture, which is an introductory lecture. I'm also trying to acclimatize myself with the system over here. Hopefully everyone can hear me. Let me just go to one last college here, just quickly check if they're able to follow. BMS, is it BMS College of Engineering? BMSC, are you able to hear me? BMS.
We can hear you.
You're in Bangalore, right? You have been able to follow what I've said so far regarding GSM Edge and so on?
Yes sir. It's clear.
Okay, so what I'm saying is basically next lecture we are going to start with some other, I'm going to start with what are some other standards, just to give you a brief overview of the development in wireless, and then we are going to start with some of the important concepts, which is how to mathematically model wireless communications, but what impact it has on wireless communication. Everyone with me? Everyone able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Let me just go to GCT. GCT, you are able to follow what I'm saying? Government College of Technology.
Sir?
You're able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You're able to follow, that is, I'm just asking. Everything is clear, audio, video, everything is clear. You're able to follow what I said so far regarding GSM, Edge, etc.?
Everything is clear, sir.
Okay. All right, good. Thank you. So I'm going to stop here. And basically we will continue with this in the next lecture. I'm getting some questions from VIT, and we can talk about these in the next lecture. All right. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. So let me just stop with this. We'll take again on Wednesday. Thank you.